The coronavirus outbreak and the impending recession have a lot of construction businesses worried about cash flow, project delays, slow payments, etc. In this video, we're going to tell you about some documents that can increase the likelihood of smooth payments during these turbulent times. Remember, there's a standalone video for each document mentioned in this video, so subscribe to our channel and dig into our library of videos for more resources. Now, let's get started. The first payment document you should know about is the preliminary notice. Preliminary notices are sent at the beginning of every job, and they let others know that you're present. Ultimately, they're really just a transparency and communication document, and it opens lines of communication from the very start of the job and lets everybody know that you're there. By doing that, it's easier for them to release payments down through the chain. Another key payment document is a payment application, and it's really more than one document. Typically, it's a bundle of documents. Ultimately, though, what it is it's a request for payment, and making sure that your pay app is up to snuff is a very crucial part of making sure that you're paid on time. On any given project, your customer or others on the job may have specific requirements for pay applications, so it's important to understand those requirements from the start of the job. That way, when it comes time to get paid, there's no delay. Another important payment document is an invoice reminder. An invoice reminder is just like it sounds. It's a simple reminder, but it's a formal reminder to your customer and to others on the job that you're still not paid. And by providing that little nudge, it's easier to make sure that you get paid without things turning into a payment dispute. Another crucial payment document is a payment demand letter. A payment demand letter ratchets things up a notch. It lets your customer know that you're unpaid and you're not happy about it, and that you're willing to do what it takes to make sure that you get paid. Generally, it'll include legal threats and maybe even set a deadline for making payment. And upon receipt, your customer will know that you mean business. If payments are coming slowly, or if there's a payment dispute on hand, a notice of intent to lien can go a long way to getting paid. A notice of intent to lien is essentially just a mechanic's lien threat. It lets your customer know that you're unpaid, that you're unhappy about it, and that you're willing to file a lien if you have to. A notice of intent to lien is also usually sent to the property owner and to any other higher tiered parties in the project, like the general contractor. And sending them this notice will let them know that you're unpaid as well. And sometimes this will be the first time they're even hearing about your payment dispute. So that can put additional pressure on your customer to make sure that you get paid. In a handful of states, a notice of intent to lien will actually be required, so it's important to check your state requirements. Finally, yet another payment recovery document is a mechanic's lien. Most people are probably familiar with mechanic's liens in the construction industry, but essentially it's a claim against the property title. Whenever a contractor, subcontractor, supplier, anyone up and down the payment chain goes unpaid, they may be entitled to file a mechanic's lien. And when that claim is filed, it's a charge against the property title, and it's officially in the property records. That'll make it a lot harder for an owner to sell their property, to transfer it, to take out a mortgage, to take out any other kind of loan, and generally it'll really just frustrate the owner. And whenever they become agitated, they can help put pressure on others in the payment chain to make sure that you get paid. Remember, if you're working on a public project, then a mechanic's lien won't be available and a bond claim will be more appropriate. Instead of the property title, a bond claim is actually made against a surety bond provided by the GC on the project. If you're curious about payment bond claims, we have other videos that you can find on our YouTube channel, so make sure to subscribe. Finally, a bonus document, mechanic's lien waivers. Mechanic's lien waivers act like receipts. They indicate to others that you've been paid on the job and that you're now going to forego any mechanic's lien rights you may have had. Usually, owners, general contractors, developers, higher tier parties will want mechanic's lien waivers if they're going to release payment. So this document is crucial for making sure that you're paid and paid on time. Construction projects have a lot of moving parts, and to get paid, you'll need to wrangle lots of paperwork. Hopefully you won't ever need all of these documents on a given project, but it's more important than ever to know what these documents are and how they can be used. Send your preliminary notices. If you have to, send escalation documents like invoice reminders or notices of intent to lien, and make sure you pay attention to mechanic's lien deadlines before they pass. That way, if you have to, you can protect your right to get paid for the hard work that you do. We hope this video has been really helpful to you, and if you're looking for help automating your payment paperwork, give us a call today. And remember, payment help is here.